I thought that this story was real interesting, being that I try my best to propagate that the black woman is God. This also ties in with the black nationalist movement agenda. Now, whenever you hear the word agenda, people tend to think that that word agenda, you know, always means something negative, like there's a negative reason behind what it is that you're doing. Now, to some racist whites, yeah, what we doing is wrong. We should adhere to their Europeanized perception of reality. We need to subject ourselves to European rule, except that they are our masters and we are nothing more than ignorant niggers or Negroes. Before I really get into this, I want to shout out the new subscribers to the channel. My name is Brother Damuzi or Brother Tammuz, whichever one you want to call me. They both mean the same thing. This channel is specifically for pissing off racist white people. That's what this channel is for. You can check out the content, see what this thing is all about, but I do dive into other subject matters. Being that I am a supporter of Black Lives Matter, I catch flack from conscious people as well. You know, not just racist whites, but conscious people as well. Now, I'm pretty sure that I may receive some flack from this article and my perception or my perspective concerning this subject matter, but everyone's entitled to their own opinions. I'm not saying that my opinion is 100% right, but then again, I am African-centered minded. So my perception is coming from a place of Africanness. So getting right into this article from The Griot. If y'all haven't subscribed to The Griot's channel, I'm going to leave their YouTube link in the description. And then the article will also be posted in the description box so that you can check out their website. But The Griot is specifically for black people. They make us look good, you know what I'm saying, and you know, things like that. So getting right into this article, Kate Michelle, negative comments only come from black women. A lot of people tend to think that I just make excuses for black people, you know, and I received a lot of that flack when the Steve Stephens incident happened. And concerning that, you know, I was coming from the ideology and the philosophy of who I consider a teacher as well, as my teacher as well, Dr. Umar Johnson, who says that the reason for black on black crime is poor education and economic castration. Keep in mind that that also applies to subject matters like this. The poor education and the economic castration has to build its way up to the committing of crimes. Okay, weak-minded African American who are overtaken by their emotions, they become puppets to be used by the invisible hand, as our brother Brother Ben X tells us. So getting right into it. Recently, Kate Michelle took to Twitter to lament the way she is treated by other black women. When I look at negative comments from people that don't know me, the only bad comments are from black women. Thoughts. She tweeted out. She continued on to blast the black community for often being negative against each other,
right? And how can one complain of racial profiling and discrimination when we are just as guilty of the same crimes towards each other? Now, I'm pretty sure, you know, there are some racist white people eating this up. They need this kind of publicity, you know what I'm saying, to make their position on racism and discrimination valid, as though it's only us as the poison. Like we are the poison of society. It may seem that way. Hell, probably is. But like I always say, black people who have the crab bucket mentality, you have to really take into consideration, how did those black people get that way? If you say it's because of their environment, well, who made the environment that way? Every question we ask ourselves about our community, about ourselves and our problems and our situations and our circumstances, it all leads back to one group of people, the white man. Black people do not have this crab in the bucket mentality. You know what I'm saying? This was never us. It was never us. That is the American us. And if we weren't this way when we were in Africa, then how in the hell did we get this way if we're from Africa? And we're not talking about Africans today who live in European civilized societies. I'm talking about black people or Africans today who still hold to their traditions, their rituals. You look at those Africans, and I can't remember the name of the tribe, but there is a tribe that whenever a member of their tribe commits a crime, they're punished and then they are exonerated. For lack of a better word, and the community lifts that person up, encourages them to do better, to be better, you know. And I can't remember the name of that tribe, but that's a tradition that still goes on to this day. When white people talk about how those particular Africans are not civilized, they are coming from a European perception of reality. They believe that the entire world should live the way that Europeans live, or live the way that Europeans have propagated that life should be, based on their perception. She decried how angry people on the internet are, and lamented that we have several of my peers who promote unity and black people bash them. And that's what I was talking about earlier, in the video, about how just because you have a different perception or perspective on certain subject matters, people who outsiders will affiliate you with will even have a problem with you. You know what I'm saying? Like I was saying, the conscious community, certain people in the conscious community have a problem with my perspective on certain subject matters. Perfect example is LGBTQ. That's a no-go in the conscious community. But why? You have no scientific documentation. You have no proof, no evidence as to this not being something that's natural. Even though if someone chooses that way of life, you can't stop what a person's personal preference is. You see what I'm saying? People are going to be that way. Why should I bash this person for his sexual preference or her sexual preference? You know, why should I bash them when I can get their help in doing what it is that I'm trying to do as a black nationalist? And we all know that there are more lesbians and gays you know what I'm saying, who go harder in this pro-black thing than straight people do. And I also stated the fact where no one has came to me about it yet, that homosexuals, both men and female, it's almost like they have gay senses, where they can sense other gay people in the room. And I posed this question to the conscious community, that you might not be homophobic, but if you're not homophobic and you have a problem with the homosexual community, LGBTQ, if you have a problem with them and you're not homosexual and you're not homophobic, are you scared that that homosexual man or that homosexual female will call you out as a homosexual? You see what I'm saying? So that's, you know, just a one of the many disagreements that me and the conscious community have. But this thing is supposed to be about black unity. If black comes first, why are we even thinking about what their preference is? You know what I'm saying? Sexual preference. You see what I'm saying? The only time we should be concerned about a sexual preference is if their sexual preference is a kid. That's the only time we need to be worried about sexual preference. If their sexual preference is a grown ass she male, then that's their sexual preference. I don't want to hate my people when we have enough to deal with than bringing each other down, she wrote. And the rest of the article is her tweets from Twitter. So yeah, you know, let me know what y'all think down in the comment sections, you know, of this video. Do you think that she's right? Do you think she's wrong? What do you think about what I said? Do you agree with my position, even on subject matters like LGBTQ and being pro-black? Everyone has their two cents. I'm not going to shoot anyone down for having their own opinion, but if you come with disrespect, I can meet fire with fire. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't matter to me, you know, and that's just what time it is. You know what I'm saying? So let me know what y'all think down in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. I see y'all next video. Peace.